Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So now it's revealed that Phantom Pain is Metal Gear Solid 5. Totally not a big surprise at all. Every one of us Metal Gear fans who knows the mythos already assumed this from the moment we first saw the Phantom Pain trailer. There's very obvious hints in there. We're just like, this is Metal Gear Solid 5. And because Kojima already revealed so much, you know, in his tweets, in his interviews, that Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes is supposed to be like a prelude or like the first section of Metal Gear Solid 5, we pretty much figured, yeah, Phantom Pain is pretty much Metal Gear Solid 5 and Ground Zeroes is a story that happens right before it. Although the interesting thing about the reveal of this trailer is the amount of time, that the time span. So we finally have the timeline established that Phantom Pain takes place in 1983 and that Ground Zero takes place a few weeks after the events of Peace Walker, and 9 years before Phantom Pain, which is 1974. So that's really interesting. So this is just my video and talking about some of the random things that come to mind and thinking about this reveal trailer and Metal Gear Solid 5 as a whole. And it's interesting that Kojima tried so hard to troll us this time around. And Kojima is known for his antics of really messing us with our minds when we're anticipating a game. No, I feel like not many other games in this industry really troll us this hard. Metal Gear Solid 2 is probably the biggest culprit, just because it, even in the trailers, where you can look back at the trailers now, there are sections, it's like, that's Big Shell, but the person, the character portrayed in that is Solid Snake. And then we finally get the game, it's just like 80% of the game you are playing as this completely new character who's so unlike Solid Snake, so different, and total rookie Raiden. So that was like a huge troll moment. I think Kojima was so successful. Ever since then, like, I think the gaming public has kind of been just wary or just like anticipating a troll moment for Kojima. Metal Gear Solid 3, he was pretty straightforward. Kojima released a bunch of trailers that looked so different from anything that the Metal Gear universe has felt like, and people were left speculating. You know, it's like, what was going on? This is like a flashback, or this is like, people made all kinds of weird theories. But Kojima was very straightforward that time. He said, hey, this is a game set in the 1960s, and it features Snake. So, and then he's like, it's a game featured in the 1960s featuring Snake, and people had going all crazy thoughts on it. But of course, the simple obvious explanation was the right one, and that is the prequel to the Metal Gear Solid universe. It's like the very first game in the timeline of Metal Gear Solid universe that is about Big Boss and how he came to be Big Boss. Pretty straightforward. He didn't troll us at all. Metal Gear Solid 4, leading up to that, he made some jokes here and there, but that was pretty straightforward too. In fact, I think with Metal Gear Solid 4, he revealed a lot, maybe a bit too much. I mean, I don't care about spoilers at all. Many of the Metal Gear Solid games I went into, I think Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops, in fact, that was a time I didn't have a PSP, and like, I really loved the series, so I like wanted to know more about it. And somehow, I ended up in GameFAQs, and I went in there, and they had a whole game script on there, and I read the whole thing. So before even playing Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops, I was already spoiled on the entire story. But that didn't stop me from buying a PSP eventually and playing Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops and really enjoying the crap out of it. So I personally don't really care about spoilers all that much. Even if I'm spoiled by any chance, I still enjoy the experience and I still am surprised and just am the journey of experiencing that interactive experience in the game is still something amazing to me, whether I know the ending to the game story or not. And so, MGS4 revealed a lot. The launch trailer for that thing revealed so much. Revealed like the fight between Ray and Rex. It revealed the European scenes. It revealed so much that by the time MGS4 came out, it's just like, wow, this is that game, but it has still had moments of humongous surprises. And I think that's the great thing about Kojima's Metal Gear games, is that even when it does reveal so much, there's still so many moments to just be like, what the hell just happened? Or, wow, that's interesting. That happens in the game. And Metal Gear Solid 5, This is like, he had to do something crazy unique, I think, this time. He had to do something that was going to be trolling, but I think he tried so hard to troll us that we already knew was coming that it didn't work. By the time the reveal happened, it's just like, yeah, okay. That pretty much confirms everything we assumed already. It's not a big surprise. It would have been such an amazing surprise if, because they had an interview. There was Jeff Keighley from GameTrailers.com interviewing Joaquin Mogren, who is this fake character, all bandaged up, supposedly the creative director or the head of Moby Dick Studios, which is a fake game company. It's an elaborate ruse. They have this interview. The amazing trollific thing that would have been amazing to see would have been if Joaquin Mogren was not a real person, not an actor, but a computer animated character on the Fox engine. If that was the case, that would have been quite amazing and a humongous marketing opportunity for Kojima to say, hey, you thought he looked real. You thought he was an actual person, but guess what? He was just a character animated on the Fox engine. That's how powerful our Fox engine is. That would have been amazing. Fortunately, that did not happen. But still, we get this trailer. And to me, what's interesting is such a direct the story is such a direct continuation of Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. And so, and in none of the trailers does he explain anything that happens in Peace Walker. So I feel like this is Kojima kind of saying, hey, remember that I made this really awesome game called Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker on the PSP, and it's now available to play on the 360 and the PS3 as a part of MGS HD collection? Yeah, if you haven't played it, guess what? You are not going to understand what the hell is going on in this trailer. And for those that have played it, you're going to understand almost everything in this trailer. So that was quite interesting, because that's pretty much what happened. People were like, I see the comments just like, what the fuck just happened? Like, Flaming Whales, like, what is this trailer about? What is that base? What is that blowing up? And it's just like, us fans who played Peace Walker, just like, yeah, okay. You know, we get it. Even though there's still so many mysteries behind it, that, you know, there's still a lot to answer. And I feel like Metal Gear Solid 5 is finally going to be that link between this part of the Metal Gear mythos and this part where this part is pretty much the beginning of the formation of the battle between the Patriots and Big Boss. You know, this is like that forming in itself, how the philosophers become the splinter organization between Cypher and Military Sound Frontier and Fox and X. And then there's this XOF in the middle. I don't know what that's about. But yeah, there's that split. And then Zero and Cypher eventually becomes this AI-controlled Patriots. So this is a formation story. And then there's this story, the Solid Snake mythos, where Solid Snake fights Big Boss, and then now it's the whole universe of Metal Gear is about fighting against Metal Gears that are to take the universe. So there's this humongous gap where Naked Snake starts out as wanting to stop the world from nuclear disaster by fighting Metal Gears pretty much all his life. He's been fighting Metal Gears all his life. And then he becomes the head of Foxhound and the head of Outer Heaven at the same time. And as the head of Outer Heaven, he wants to create this nuclear threat to overcome the Patriots. How does Big Boss become the Big Boss that we know in Outer Heaven? We don't really know yet, and that's the question that Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain, I think, will finally answer. I think that's like the biggest drive behind this game. And what makes it so that Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain is a numbered Metal Gear Solid title, and Peace Walker is not, and Portable Ops is not? I think there's one simple answer to that. All Metal Gear Solid games, all the numbered titles, have one common element, one common character, in all those titles, and that's Ocelot. Metal Gear Solid 1, Ocelot is the character that convinces Liquid and Snake to start this insurrection against the United States government, and thus creating the Shadow Moses incident. Metal Gear Solid 2, he's acting as a Patriot agent who is in charge of this S3 simulation plan. And Metal Gear Solid 3, he's the triple agent of CIA, GRU, and KGB, who eventually allows United States to have a hold of the philosopher's legacy. And of course, Metal Gear Solid 4, he's the main character that, by impersonating himself as Liquid Ocelot, or by Liquid Snake, he convinces the Patriots and Solid Snake to keep pursuing him until the end, so that the Patriots ultimately gets totally wiped out. In all those four games, Ocelot has such a main pivotal role. And I feel like Metal Gear Solid 5, because it actually introduces Ocelot and just very briefly in the trailer, also will have a main pivotal role. I feel like that's one of the reasons we know is it's like this is a numbered MGS title. Not to knock on Peace Walker, though. Peace Walker is an amazing game. And if the whole point of this trailer, if Kojima's point in this trailer was like, hey, you haven't played Peace Walker, that's why you don't understand it. And so you should. If that was the whole point, I totally agree. You should play Peace Walker.